Hello again. Welcome back to hacking and demo workshop session. This part of the session, so for the next 90 minutes, as you probably already heard in the morning, we have some bad news. Some of the speakers could not make it, unfortunately. We will have the first session now for 30 minutes. And if you want more time, you can have more time, of course. Then I will offer you a high-level presentation on cybersecurity challenges of the past and the future, a very non-technical one. So if you want to stay for that or invite your colleagues to come, that would be appreciated. And then we will end this session of 90 minutes, and we will have a coffee break in some time. After the coffee break, we will start with demo by Peter, and it will go on for 60 minutes. So you can compare that to your to the agenda you have here. Basically, the presentations in 1430 and 1500 hours are in there. I will fill in with one presentation about cybersecurity challenges of the past and the future. But now I would like everyone to invite Mariusz Stawowski. He will talk to us. Yes, please. He will talk to us about vulnerabilities and how to manage those vulnerabilities in a reasonable manner. And as soon as we get the slide there, that's great. We have a microphone for you too. Would you prefer questions to be held in the end?
It doesn't matter.
Okay, so if there are any questions, we can do that during the presentation or after the presentation. Yeah, you have two screens, yeah.
It's okay, thank you. Threat exposure management, nowadays it is the term that means almost the same as vulnerability management, because the vulnerability management, when this term was created, the first principle of vulnerability management was trying to fix all the vulnerabilities, and some years ago it was possible. Nowadays, realistically, such possibility does not exist, and I think that all of you will agree with me. Every day and sometimes more often, new vulnerabilities are discovered. So the approach is the approach to vulnerability management is more business oriented. So we manage, we try to find the most severe vulnerabilities. We try to look at the security bugs from the perspective of business consequences. Business consequences means disruption of business processes important for the company, or compromise of sensitive data, like personal data. So we try to manage the vulnerabilities in a more mature way. And as I said, sometimes we call it threat exposure management. Rapid7, the company that supports organization in this process, use this term, and in the technical way, I would like to explain you what this practically means. Vulnerability management, generally speaking, is part of every security standard. We can find the requirements in ISO 27001. We can find the requirements for vulnerability scanning in PCI DSS. And also, when you look at the GDPR, there is one important statement in security of processing that requires testing of security. And part of this, important part of this, is vulnerability management. What is, in reality, vulnerability management? Because in many cases, we consider this as scanning. So we have the scanner, we run it, we got the report. Vulnerability management consists of five phases. According to Rapid7 methodology, first phase is scanning, so we need to discover vulnerabilities. Sometimes in IT system we have 5,000, sometimes I know the one example of a big company, more than 20,000 of vulnerabilities in one report. So after that we need to prioritize vulnerabilities. We need to concentrate on the bugs that we should treat firstly. There is absolutely no possibility to install patches for all the vulnerabilities, maybe in a very small IT system, but in reality there are too many vulnerabilities. If somebody is stating that, yes, I am fixing all vulnerabilities, so probably he's not aware about all of them, because they exist in operating systems, databases, applications installed on desktop. And very often people responsible for security just do not know in what areas they have vulnerabilities. They have vulnerabilities sometimes in cloud services, in mobile devices, and so on. So we need to conduct the prioritization. Third, we have in every IT system virtual patching. All of our companies have virtual patching. Sometimes we do not call it virtual patching, but it is. Every next generation firewall with intrusion prevention system is virtual patching. Every, I don't know, web application firewall, database firewall, every safeguards that look for attacks and block the attack is virtual patching. Because the, for example, intrusion prevention system protects against the situation when someone, malware, exploit, use existing vulnerability to compromise the system. It's patching, virtual patching. So we need to verify if the vulnerability really can be exploited. It is the third phase. Fourth phase is preparation of a report, because we need to prepare some activities to fix, to implement real patches or to reconfigure, reinstall safeguards, add additional safeguards, so add virtual patching to close, to make smaller the attack surface. Do not allow malware or intruders to use the vulnerability. We need to prepare the plan, how we could do it, when we can do it, during weekend or in working hours, who would conduct the installation of patches, and so on. And the last phase in this circle is mitigation and remediation. So installation of patches, reconfiguration, adding additional safeguards, and so on. Very important element, very important element of this cycle is first business impact analysis. What is this? Very often we do not remember that prioritization that is provided by technical safeguards based on a so-called CVSS scoring. It is technical scoring. In marketing materials, we have information that it is risks-based, but risk is related to business of the organization, to business processes that could be disrupted, to sensitive data that could be compromised. And business impact analysis means that we should have in consideration, what consequences could have the compromise of the IT system using a particular vulnerability. In May next year, we should look at our IT system from the perspective of GDPR requirements, and we should be aware that if the breach of personal data occur, it could have very negative, generally negative consequences for the organization. The organization could expect the some kind of audit of national authority. So when conducting prioritization of vulnerabilities, we should look first at IT systems that are the most important for the company. What tools we can use? We can use Microsoft Excel if we have a lot of time, or we can use the dedicated tools that can correlate the report from vulnerability management tools with, for example, GRC technologies. And virtual patching. Not all patches are we are able to fix. So very often we can reconfigure existing safeguards to provide so-called virtual patching. It is very common that we use, for example, intrusion prevention system. We create additional security zone in next generation firewall, and we can block the attacks using particular vulnerabilities. Generally, vulnerability management or threat exposure management, it is the time-consuming process. Everybody, I think, agree with me. There are a lot of areas where vulnerabilities could exist, from operating system, databases, applications, mobile endpoints, applications written or developed for a particular business needs, and so on. There are a lot of areas. And how complex this process is, you can just look at OWASP top 10. OWASP top 10 critical vulnerabilities, it is, as the name indicates, the list of 10 the most severe vulnerability types in web application firewalls. On this slide, you have presented how the vulnerabilities are evolving. This area is changing rapidly, and also our strategy for vulnerability management should be adjusted to the current situation. We should look what vulnerabilities nowadays are the most severe and be prepared to first detect such vulnerabilities, second, have the ability to mitigate them. In this case, for web vulnerabilities like SQL injections, like cross-site scripting, we need educated pen tester, or we need dedicated vulnerability scanners, because most of the scanners do not detect the errors in the code of web application. It should be dedicated tool that is able to simulate SQL injection attack and verify if really such vulnerability exists and what could be the consequences of using this vulnerability. If we have a lot of so-called false positives, it is very negative for entire process, because you can waste a lot of time verifying the vulnerabilities that in reality do not exist. So we need good tools. We have no possibility to fix all the vulnerabilities, so we need to concentrate on the bugs existing in the most important IT systems of the organization. This process is called threat exposure management. And when you look at this slide, you see that in reality there are no safe systems. Every smartphone, tablet, endpoint, server, and every application has vulnerabilities. There are no safe systems nowadays. The vulnerabilities could be used by malware or intruders for incident. Incident is something that we should be, I don't know, very familiar with, because there are a lot of incidents, and incident is dangerous for us, but we should not be paranoid. A lot of incidents, a lot of computers with malware, a lot of applications trojanized. The art of security management is to find the incidents in IT systems that are the most important for the company and be faster than cyber criminals. Because cyber criminals needs, practically looking at some statistics, they need at least 2 weeks to analyze the system and to find the way to steal, for example, confidential data. So the incident does not means automatically breach. Breach occurs in most cases after some time. Of course, you can tell me there are some examples, for example, ransomware, then incident means breach in most cases. But it is only the example. In most incidents, the intruders are in IT systems for many weeks, many months sometimes. Please remember the situation in Ukraine in 2015 when cyber criminals switched off in three energy distribution companies. They switched off energy. And for more than 6 months, they were penetrating systems. So incident occurred 6 months before the breach. So in our strategy for risk management, for vulnerability management, for incident management, we should try concentrate on the most important systems and try to find the flaws in these systems, fix these flaws, because in reality, we are not able to fix all vulnerabilities or react quickly for all incidents in every IT system or every area in our environment. And this environment is becoming more and more complex, mostly because of mobile and cloud. Some people still think that I am not using cloud. My company is not in cloud. So just ask the question, do you use Office 365? Yes, because licensing is more efficient for me. So you have the cloud. Ask your business if they are using some Salesforce. No, they are not using. Ask them. They are using Salesforce? Yes, because we are cooperating with some business partners and they provided us some tools for business. We are using cloud. So in many cases, the companies are using cloud and they are not, or the people responsible for security are not aware that the employees are using cloud. A lot of applications installed on mobile, on smartphones and tablets automatically use cloud and they do not inform the employee, the user that they use some cloud services. Okay, so the art, the realistic strategy is to look at IT systems from the perspective of business and on the most important IT systems find severe vulnerabilities and try to fix them as soon as possible, just to avoid breaches in this kind of systems. Without dedicated tools, of course, it could be academic discussion here if open source is better than commercial. If in your company you have security experts, real security experts in pen testing, you have the team, you can use open source. That's okay. But if you do not have a team of professionals, in most cases you need commercial dedicated tools. I will very quickly go through Rapid7 tools. It is one of the most common tools, very popular in enterprises. Also, pen testers are using this kind of tools. And I will show you how these tools could be used for the, I don't know how to call it, next generation or the modern kind of vulnerability management. First tool is Nexpose. In every company, this kind of tool should be available. It is the vulnerability scanner for common elements of IT system, for endpoints, for mobile devices, for servers, for network devices, databases, and so on. It is a scanner that collects the information, prioritizes the information, and provides some recommendations, where to find the fixes, what kind of fixes should be used, for example, in Oracle, in the Microsoft operating system, Android, and so on. Additional tool in most companies also needed is AppSpider. AppSpider, it is a dedicated vulnerability scanner for web applications, for the flows like SQL injection, cross-site scripting, and similar problems in the code of HTML and all other web technologies. It also works in a similar way, collects the information about problems, prioritize them, and provide the recommendation how to fix it. If you know, in web applications, you can use two remediation strategies. First strategy is to ask developer to change the code, to fix in the application code the error made by developers. And second possibility is use so-called web application firewall. You can also use some simple methods of blocking attacks, like mod security, where you define the sequence of attack and try to, looking at the data that flows to the application, try to find this kind of signatures or regular expression and try to block it, but it is very, very inefficient. My company, I mean Clico, is providing security audits, and our pen testers are very, for us it's very easy to find that the vulnerability is not fixed, it is just there is some kind of filter that tries to look for the strings using this discovered vulnerability and try to block this string. Probably my explanation is a bit complicated, but most of you, I hope, understand what I mean. I mean that, to summarize, to fix the vulnerability in web application, there are only two efficient ways. One, developer just fix it using so-called input validation procedures, or use the web application firewall. That using the dedicated techniques, the defined profile of the protected application can detect and block such attack. Metasploit, if you are interested in hacking, for many years Metasploit package was an open source, still it is open source, so the world of pen tester, the world of white and black hackers are very familiar with Metasploit. It's one of the most, still one of the most advanced and most flexible tools to conduct penetration testing. And in vulnerability management process or vulnerability management cycle, Metasploit could be used to verify if really the vulnerability could be exploited, because Nexpose, the vulnerability scanner, detects the vulnerability, but you do not know if we are able to exploit this vulnerability or not. So we can use Metasploit and verify if really we can hack the system. So Metasploit, it's some kind of hacker in a box, we can call it in this way. What is nice in Rapid7? Nice thing is that the company, the security researchers, cooperate with community. Still Nexpose and Metasploit are available for community, and the community is developing this and using this. What's the difference between commercial and non-commercial tools? Commercial are dedicated for corporations. In most cases, just to simplify my thought, for non-professionals. If you are not good in hacking, do not use Metasploit, because you will waste a lot of time. Probably you would conduct the tests in an inappropriate way. Use the commercial tool. In commercial tool, you have some additional console, and you can use Metasploit in the way that you just configure IP addresses, run, and all the testing, all the vulnerability management would be conducted for you. If you are a security expert, you can use the free of charge platform of Metasploit. It is the same from the exploits point of view, from the evasion techniques, from the ability to send payload that bypass the safeguards. It is the same. However, you need the skills. You need to be real professional to use it. The benefit for companies using commercial version of this kind of tools is that the community, thousands of thousands world professionals, are developing this kind of tool, defining new exploits, discovered for new vulnerabilities, and so on. What are the features of threat management exposure? First feature in current world is dynamic discovery of attack surface. Attack surface means way to exploit the system, attack the system. The IT world is changing. For example, we have new endpoints connecting to new systems. We have new mobile devices connecting to IT systems and connecting to cloud. We have new applications installed on tablets or smartphones. Virtualized world, like VMware, Citrix, Microsoft Virtual Environment. It's from the nature, it is very dynamic. Administrator with one click, run or activate new virtual machine. So in vulnerability management, also cloud as well. In vulnerability management, we should be aware about dynamic nature of IT systems, and we should have tools that automatically, I will emphasize this, automatically, without the additional obligations of administrators, of security engineers, the tools automatically detect the change and automatically run the vulnerability scanning for the elements of IT system that was changed, for new applications, for new virtual machines, for new desktops, new mobile devices, and so on. And using mentioned Rapid7 tools, we have the ability to monitor, for example, DHCP events, monitor VMware events, integrate the tools with NSX, VMware NSX, look at cloud services, cloud environments, and based on the logs of these environments, the scanner can automatically run additional scanning for new tools and automatically, also automatically, inform us about new discovered vulnerabilities in new elements of IT system. Automated vulnerability validation. Virtual patching. Virtual patching is very effective way to fix, maybe not fix, temporary fix vulnerabilities. And very quickly, using dedicated tools, we can, in our company, verify if really vulnerability is exploitable in our environment, because we have safeguards. We have safeguards locally, we have safeguards in the network, we have firewalls that do not allow for access, we have intrusion prevention systems that look for attacks in the network traffic. Technically, the process is very simple. You run an expose and verify vulnerabilities and automatically transfer the report of discovered vulnerabilities to Metasploit, and Metasploit conducts the tests verifying if existing vulnerabilities are exploitable. If they are exploitable and they exist in important IT systems, it means supporting the important business processes or processing sensitive company information, in that case, immediately we should remediate or prepare the remediation plan for these vulnerabilities. Visibility, it is something that is also very important for vulnerability management, because when we talk about, generally speaking, security management or risk management, we emphasize that the size, the complexity of our IT systems are growing, and we need dedicated tools that in graphical way present us the results, describe the state in understandable way. Also in vulnerability management, in this case in Rapid7 live boards, it is the name of tool, we can analyze thousands of vulnerabilities in different perspectives and decide which vulnerabilities we should mitigate first. We also have some integrated tools that help us to prioritize vulnerabilities. For example, there is analysis If we fix this one particular vulnerability, we are able to reduce risk, for example, in, 72%, because this vulnerability exists in, for example, 200 systems. These systems are visible for potential intruders, and it is severe vulnerability. So if only this one vulnerability will be fixed in our network, the risk level would be, for example, decreased in 72%. Such information is very useful because we can take proper actions to be efficient. We are not able practically to reduce the risk to zero, but we should use our time, use our resources to work effectively and try to decrease the risk level to as lowest level as possible. The dedicated tools can help us. Flexible and scalable architecture, it is very common for vulnerability management tools that they can work in distributed environments. If our network is geographically distributed, we can install scan engine in, for example, branches and central management console in the headquarter and have central vulnerability management. Defense in depth is the strategy that by most of security analytics is the only effective security strategy. So we do not have only one element of security, we have many elements that support each other. There is no possibility to create security element that is unbroken. We are able to create a security system consisted of many elements that support each other, the elements that are able to even detect that one element is not working properly, that was bypassed. So we have many security levels. When we look at vulnerability management scope, we have vulnerability management and additional layers as virtual patching, authenticated scans, and business-aware vulnerability management. When you look into your IT system, probably you will find many other layers that could be integrated. And very shortly, I will explain how we can use it practically. Some examples. If you have the Nexpos, the Rapid7 tool mentioned by me on the previous slide, when you AppSpider, web application scanning. If you scan the application, you discover that in the application you have, for example, 200 vulnerabilities. You can import this scanner into the web application firewall, and almost automatically, web application firewall, in this case Imperva, is able to create vulnerability management, create virtual patches that do not allow for exploitation of the flaws. You can integrate vulnerability scanner with privileged access management tools, like in this case with Rapid7. It can be used for so-called authenticated scans. Authenticated scans means that scanner is logging into the system and from inside is conducting the verification of configuration, installed patches. It is very detailed, very accurate vulnerability scanning. We can use the standards, the recommendations of recognized institutions like NSA, like CIS, and verify if the configuration of particular system is compliant with the recommendations. And in this case, to conduct so-called authenticated scans, we can use CyberArk, that is dedicated privileged access management tool. The integration is very simple. How to conduct business impact analysis. You can integrate scanning with GRC system. GRC means governance, risk management, compliance. In this case, you can automatically conduct business impact analysis for discovered vulnerabilities. And it is, I think, the easiest and the fastest way to prioritize vulnerabilities in the business context. That's all that I wanted to tell you. If you have any questions, if you would like to verify, to test the presented tools during presentation, please contact me. We are able to provide you the software, in most cases in virtual machines, and the license required to conduct the tests. The tools are very useful and used by many customers, many organizations in the world. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you very much. Do we have a couple of questions for Mr. Stawowski? I'll use this opportunity to remind everybody here and people waiting outside that the next speaker couldn't make it. We will have a presentation, but it's not going to be the one on there. So are there any questions for the speaker? I guess I'll start. So you mentioned automating the management of vulnerabilities, finding, for getting the list and testing them as Metasploit later. Now for the getting part, is that basically just outsourcing your job of trying to find all the vulnerabilities to a third party? I mean, the problem in the market and is in the scene as a whole is that not all researchers publish, get CVs or publish them centralized. So what's your proposed solution to that? And I'll get you your mic.
Could you please once again explain what was the...
Sure, of course.
The question, because it was...
Yes. So you proposed the solution for automatically getting a list of vulnerabilities and testing if they apply. That's correct, yeah?
One part. The vulnerability management is much more complicated than you only using one or two tools. First of all, we have many areas that where the vulnerabilities could exist. So first we need to identify if our vulnerabilities are related to cloud, to mobile devices. Very often we are not aware that we have such vulnerabilities, and only when the breach occurs, we see some new light looking, and this light is, for example, in the area where we were not aware. So first we need to conduct the risk analysis, and based on the risk analysis for identified areas where the vulnerabilities could exist, we should prioritize if for the business these areas are important or not. If they are important, we should think about appropriate tools. Such tools exist, mentioned by me, Rapid 7 tools could be used for most of areas, could be used to analyze the endpoints, the servers, cloud services, mobile devices, even the virtualized environment. So we can run a scanner inside, for example, VMware NSX, conducting vulnerability management from inside, even analyzing the virtual machines that are not active. So the tools, generally speaking, allow us to conduct vulnerability management in any environment. We can use a set of tools, for example, in Rapid7, Nexpose, integrated with Metasploit. For web applications, we can use AppSpider. For virtual patching, we can use Imperva web application firewall. For authenticated scans, we can automate the process using the privilege access management from CyberArk, for example. For business impact analysis, automatically we can conduct it using SecureVisio GRC. But first, we need to conduct risk analysis, and based on the areas where the level of the risk is high, we should plan appropriate tools and appropriate procedures to conduct the scanning. Of course, you could find the situation where the mentioned by me tools are not enough. So if these tools are not enough for the environment, for your environment, it is natural to look for other tools. There is no, let's say, universal tool that you can use everywhere. For example, in SCADA systems, how to verify vulnerabilities in industrial control systems. Vulnerability scanning is possible when you have test environment for the production environment. If you run the scanner, you can disturb the industrial processes, and for example, power grid would be disrupted, or the energy transfer would be disrupted, or the factory would be, or part of the factory could be destroyed. So every environment needs planning. For mentioned by me SCADA systems, maybe instead of active vulnerability scanning, use the authenticated scan that the scanner connects to the operating system and verifies from inside without sending active samples of exploits to the system and risk that this system could be disrupted. I don't know if I was able to
answer.
You
clarified the process a lot. Thank you so much. Is there a question in the audience? If not, then once again, can we have a huge round of applause for Mariusz here? There's a certificate, of course, for participation. May I shake your hand? And a gift bag from the organizers. Whoa, that's too much. Okay, there you go.